Hi guys, my name is Pete and I'm from Australia. I am the general manager and partner of Excellent Edges. I've been hairdressing for 24 years. I bought my first scissor maybe 2 years into my career and love the concept so much. And over the last 18, I've been allowed to grow with these tools. So much so that 10 years ago, I left working my salon, working full time behind the floor, become an educator for Excellent Edges. This is the Crocodile. This is maybe one of the most misunderstood scissors in the world, but it's also one of my favorites. It is a texturizer that is like no other in the world. It has 10 teeth, each with a little micro slot to catch hair, and a slot at the back for my channeling and pivoting. It can be very, very soft, or it can be very, very hard. It depends on how you use it and your angle to the hair. You will also find when we use it, if you run it across, everything makes softer. So I can cut blunt lines, but softer. I can slice, but it's also softer again. The main reason is also how I use it is this cutting blade. If I want the texture to be internally on the hair, I will come in this way and close. And you'll see I leave no lines on the outside of my haircut. If I was to have this scissor around the other way, I'd be in a lot of problems because, as you can see, I cut lines straight in. This is why we have two tangs on our scissor. Some companies say this is for left and right-handed, but it's actually not. It is so we can maneuver and change the angle. Make the cutting blade on top for harder external texture, turn the blade around the other way for internal and soft texture that can't be seen visually to the eye, but for a customer, they'll know it's there because their hair will spring. I can use this scissor very softly straight into the hair, and what it will do will add texture to the hair, but incredibly, incredibly soft. You can see how I hardly take any hair out. As I change my angle, you'll notice then that it actually becomes a little bit more aggressive as I run it across my hair in a hard point cutting technique. You'll see I start to remove my design line. I can then turn this and work across the hair and create solid blunt lines. But the end result is it's very soft to touch. So when you drop this out, it's incredibly seamless, but beautiful, beautiful ends. This scissor, no other scissor in the world can replicate what you can do with this scissor. That's our promise to you. If I want to separate and add a lot of internal texture to a hair, especially when I've got like a bobbed length, what I'll do is I'll pick up my whole section of hair. I'll come in. I'll make sure, once again, that this cutting blade is closest to the scalp, and I'll come in vertically to my section. And drop out. As you can see, I remove a fair amount of hair through here and add texture to it, but nothing is visible to the eye on the outside. I can then raise, elevate slightly less, come through, soft again. As long as I am making sure that this cutting blade is the closest, I create texture through the hair, seamless, no line. When working with the croc is beautiful to work through curly hair as well. Because there is no clear cut definite line when you're cutting with this, it's also the same with the texture of curly hair. There's no clear cut definite shape. So I manipulate my scissor with a curl and a twist, and then come through with my clock, and I work more on the base and just channel through. It's very, very light. But once again, seamless texture. It's a beautiful technique for all curly hair clients. So now I'm going to work on a really, really loose fringe. I also work with a crocodile for this, once again with my cutting blade always closest to the scalp for internal texture. I work vertically into my section, almost at eyebrow level, underneath the fringe. As you can see, there is nothing on the outside. I then step down a little bit lower and do the same technique. What this will give me is a very loose fringe that doesn't have any weight in it, so it's very easily manipulated for a customer. So they can sweep it from side to side or wear messy and separate. I can easily come in and work straight into the hair. And as I come into the center of the hair, I increase my angle across my blade, meaning that it will actually take out more hair. I work the other way, coming straight up into the hair, and as I get closer to the center, I increase the angle. What this will do is create a little V that will separate the hair and make it sit really, really loose. Our company philosophy is scissors for the serious. For me, if you're serious about your craft and you want the best tools available, that's us.